If there are particular types of text you frequently drop into your documents, text you have to format in a very specific way over and over again, I've got a time-saving tip for you coming up. Hi, I'm Deborah Savadra of Legal Office Guru, your resource for legal professionals using Microsoft Office. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how to set up styles to deal with two specific types of text I see in briefs all the time, block quotes and deposition text. What these have in common is they're both formatted in very specific ways that are markedly different from the other paragraphs in the brief. Block quotes are usually indented half an inch on both sides and are single-spaced, while quotations of deposition text use a hanging indent to sort of hang the Q and A off to the left while indenting the actual questions and answers. You may or may not already know how to manually format each of these text types, but I'm going to go over that formatting step by step, then show you how you can save that formatting into custom styles so you can replicate that formatting on any block of text with literally one click. Imagine how much time and frustration that could save. Let's get started. You may run into situations where you have a particular type of formatting that's not already had a style assigned to it. Here is hands down the easiest way to make your own style by using an example you've already got. The two examples I'm going to use here are block quotes and depo text because they're pretty common in the practice areas I work in, and the formatting is fiddly enough that I don't want to have to do it over and over again. But obviously you don't have to do either of those. If there's a type of formatting that you'd like to have one-click access to, you can make a style for that instead. First, let me show you what formatting is embedded in these two examples. First, for block quotes, I'm single-spacing the text and indenting it half an inch on either side. I'm also putting 12 points of space between each paragraph, so I'm not having to enter twice at the end of each paragraph. In the second example, depo text, because the Q and A need to be hanging out at the left-hand margin while the rest of the paragraph is indented, I'm going to use the hanging indent feature from the paragraph dialog box to control that. These will also be single-spaced and have 12 points of space after each paragraph. So this is hands down the easiest method for creating a new style. Simply format some text the way you want the style to appear, then select it, right-click on it, click Styles, then Create a Style. You could also use the drop-down up here in the Styles area on the Home tab to get to that same dialog box. Now the temptation here is just to click OK and use that smaller dialog box to finish, but what I tend to recommend to people is to go ahead and click Modify and go into the fuller dialog box to actually make the choices we talked about earlier. Specifically for the block quote style, I'm going to make this a paragraph style type, as opposed to a linked style type, since I don't want the block quote style to change the font of whatever document I use it in. The only formatting I'm using in this style is paragraph level formatting, specifically indentation and line spacing. So that's suited to a paragraph style. It's also going to be based on the normal style, so it inherits the normal formatting of whatever document I use it in. And when I use the block quote style and press enter, I want it to return to normal and not continue in block quote. So I put normal in the field style for following paragraph. That's a personal preference. You may prefer to do something different. And since I want to have easy access to this style within my documents, I'm going to be sure to check the Add to Styles Gallery box so that I'll always see that in the Styles area of the Home tab. Plus, I want this style to be available on any document I use the normal template for, so I'll select the radio button next to New Documents based on this template. Again, I'll walk through the same choices for the depo text style. It's going to be a paragraph style type. Since the formatting is just having a hanging indent and putting a little space between the questions and answers, and it's also going to be based on the normal style, so it'll inherit other formatting characteristics from it. This time, however, whenever I hit enter when using this style, I'm going to want it to continue in this style instead of reverting to normal, because if I'm typing a long section of deposition testimony, I don't want to have to reset the style over and over again. Then I'm going to go down here and make sure this box next to Add to the Styles Gallery is checked, and that the radio button next to New Documents based on this template is selected. So I'll have this depo text style available in any document I create using the normal template. Once I click OK, that style's ready to go. Now, if you think I'm doing a bit of a sales job on using styles, you're absolutely right. I'm really sold on leveraging this feature in Word, and I'm trying to get as many people in law offices and law departments to start using styles too. As I've said before, literally every piece of text you touch has one or more styles attached to it, so it's working in the background of your documents whether you realize it or not. Learning how to use styles intelligently can make you a whole lot more efficient and less frustrated. And if you're in the middle of preparing a brief and you're having trouble keeping up with all the court's formatting requirements, maybe I can help. I've got a brief requirements checklist you can download free that'll help you sort through your court's various rules and get all your requirements in one place for easy reference. Just check the link above or in the description below to get your free checklist today.